Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates faster than anybody else. Now friends, welcome to another video on your channel Profit and Equities. Now if you like our content, please don't forget to hit the like button. Also subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates at the earliest. Now IDFC Securities is a top institutional brokerage firm from India. Here we share 4 mid-cap stock recommendations from them post budget 2018. Now the factor to note here is that all these stocks are part of a research which they have done where 2 major factors are what they have arrived at. Now, the domestic brokerage firm believes that 2 themes would predominantly play out as the economy recovers, and it is asset heavy and export oriented industries would do well as the global economy recovers, and consequently the valuation gap between asset heavy and asset light industries would narrow further. And secondly, the consumption being the strongest component of GDP will continue to see growth impetus from retail credit. Now, they have gone ahead and provided some mid-cap stocks and also some large-cap stocks. In this first video, we would be showing to you the mid-cap bets, and consequently at a later date, we would be providing to you the large-cap bets from IDFC Securities. Now, friend, please don't just jump in. Go ahead and do your own research. And also, we will be providing the link to this article in the description. Please go ahead and watch it at your convenience. And this would help you build conviction around your buy or sell decision. Please watch this video to know more. Now, the first stock on the list and a personal favorite of ours is Kajaria Ceramics Limited, which is available at 616.15. And the target price here has been set at 776. The code for the company is KAJARIACER. Now, Kajaria Ceramics Limited is a holding company. The company is a tile company engaged in the manufacturing and trading of ceramics, polished and glazed vitrified tiles. It offers products including ceramic wall and floor tiles, polished vitrified tiles, glazed vitrified tiles, and sanitary ware and faucets. Its glazed vitrified tiles are marketed in metros and urban cities through its network comprising Kajaria World, Kajaria Galaxy, Kajaria Studio, and other multi-brand dealers. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that the stock is pretty much ending the year at almost the same level at which it started it. But towards the middle of the year, the stock was on an uptrend, but it could not sustain it. The market cap of the company is 9,792.96 crores, which means the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 16.17, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 38.10, which is slightly more expensive compared to the industry PE of 33.90. The book value is 74.22, which translates into a price to book ratio of 8.30, which is on the higher side. The dividend yield for the company is 0.49, whereas the promoter holding here is average at 47.58. The 52-week high for the company stands at 789.80, whereas the 52-week low for the company is at 509.50. Now, IDFC Securities believes that organized players will continue to gain market share from unorganized players led by GST implementation in the medium term. However, in the near term, unorganized players have gained given the delay in the introduction of the e-way bill. This, along with a sharp increase in fuel prices, has led to cut in estimates from IDFC Securities, and this has been pretty sharp in nature. Now, IDFC Securities estimates 14.6% volume CAGR and strong 27.5% earnings CAGR over FY18 to 20E on the back of operating leverage kicking in. Now, JV issues are also getting sorted, and higher contribution of sanitary ware slash faucet division is also a positive factor going forward for the company. Now, with industry leading market share, margins and high return ratio profile, they expect the stock to command industry leading multiples provided growth does not decelerate. Now, the second stock on the list is SpiceJet Limited, and it is currently available at 141.65. Whereas the target price here has been set at 173. The code for the company is SPICEJET. Now, SpiceJet Limited is an India-based company engaged in the transportation of passengers by air. The company is engaged in the business of scheduled air transport services. Its geographical segments include India and others. It provides air transport services for the carriage of passengers and cargo. The company is a low-cost carrier operating under the brand name of SpiceJet in India. The company operates a fleet of approximately 40 aircrafts, including approximately 7 aircraft taken on wet lease across various routes in India and abroad. Now, if you were to see that even though there has been a fall in the stock prices recently, but overall the stock has been on a consistent uptrend throughout the year. The market cap of the company is 8491.21 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 9.38, translating into a price-to-earnings ratio of 15.10. The industry PE is 26.30, which means that the company is much more cheaper compared to the industry PE. The book value is a negative minus 10.16. And if you were to look at the dividend yield, this company does not currently pay out any dividends. The promoter holding here is decent at 60.03, whereas the 52-week high for the company stands at 156.25. The 52-week low for the company stands at 59.40. Now, if you were to look at the reasons, now SpiceJet continues to invest in rebuilding its brand and in improving its service offerings. Its bold route strategy involves a greater focus on non-trunk routes, has strong growth prospects, and is already earning the company better yields. Also, they believe SpiceJet's balance sheet will continue to strengthen with strong cash generation. Now, the third company on the list is Ashoka Buildcon Limited, and the current market price here is 245.20. The target price here has been set at 312, and the code for the company is ASHOKA. Now, Ashoka Buildcon Limited is an India-based infrastructure development company. The company is engaged in the construction and maintenance of roads and also provides supporting services to land support operations of toll roads. It also operates in other segments. The company operates through three segments: construction and contract-related activities, BOT projects, and sales of goods. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that towards the middle of the year, there was a sort of a rounding bottom formation as far as the chart is concerned. And recently, in the savage market correction that is underway, this stock has also depreciated in value. The market cap of the company is 4588.89 crores, which means the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 11.33, which translates into a price-to-earnings ratio of 21.64, which is much cheaper compared to the industry PE of 41.43. The book value is 99.61, which translates into a price-to-book ratio of 2.46. One concerning fact for this company is the debt-to-equity, and this is at a very high number of 4.2853. Now, the consoling factor may be that companies in the infrastructure sector generally trade with high debts. The dividend yield percent is 0.65, whereas the promoter holding here is 54.81 and is average. The 52-week high for the company stands at 268.95, whereas the 52-week low for the company stands at 155. Now, the final company on the list is Greenply Industries Limited, which is available at 367.35, and the target price here has been set at 390. The code for the company is GRWNPLY. Now, Greenply Industries Limited is an interior infrastructure company. The company is engaged in the business of manufacturing plywood and allied products, medium density fiber boards, and allied products through its factories at various locations. The company's segments include plywood and allied products and medium density fiber boards and allied products. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that initially the company was in a consolidation mode, but towards the latter half of the year, the company went on a massive spike, but of late in the market correction that is underway, the stock has again fallen. The market cap is 4,504.72 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 11.82, which translates into a price-to-earnings ratio of 31.08, which is much cheaper compared to the industry PE of 38.71. The book value is 64.18, which translates into a price-to-book ratio of 5.72.
The dividend yield percent is on the lower side at 0.16, whereas the promoter holding here is average at 51.03. The 52-week high for the company stands at 401.10, whereas the 52-week low for the company stands at 244.80. Now, if we were to look at the reasons why this has been set forward as a potential beneficiary, IDFC Securities expects Greenply to benefit from the recent boost in GST, which has been by having the GST rate lowered to 18%, which will accelerate the shift in market share towards organized players. Also, going revival in the real estate will aid growth in their view. Moreover, its MDF and plywood business are expected to come on stream from mid of FY19E. With its new MDF plant, Greenply will own almost close to 45% of India's MDF capacity, and with increasing adoption of MDF in India, Greenply is poised to grow well in the medium term. IDFC Securities thus expects Greenply's earnings to double over FY17 to 20E, with most of it being back-ended. Now, friends, please don't treat this as a stock recommendation. Go ahead and do your own research. And this is all what we wanted to show you for today. Thanks for watching, and we will see you soon with another video.